And now let's turn to politics. The death of Supreme Court Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg a month and a half before the election has set up quite the clash on Capitol Hill. For that, I want to bring in Julia Manchester over at the Hill to break it all down. Julia, great to see you as always. So, of course, Mitch McConnell ripping up the votes here. Essentially, we now know Susan Collins, Lisa Murkowski, both coming out saying that they plan to not vote on whoever Mitch McConnell puts up for a vote until after the election. So now all eyes essentially on Mitt Romney and Cory Gardner of Colorado. What are the chances that either one of them actually break and join those two other senators?
Absolutely. And I would add maybe even Iowa Senator Chuck Grassley to that list. You know, Cory Gardner in particular is facing a very uphill battle, re-election battle in his home state of Colorado. So that is definitely something that could will likely go into his strategy in deciding what to do on this issue. I mean, he is trailing in the polls in that state against former Governor John Hickenlooper. And we know that this is something that the Democrats are going to bring in to that race, the Supreme Court pick. We know that this pick, due to record fundraising this weekend, is really galvanizing that liberal vote in states across the country. So definitely expect that to go into consideration with Cory Gardner and his decision on this. Mitt Romney, someone who has broken with the president in the past, even voting to impeach him on one count earlier this year. So I would not be surprised if Mitt Romney cites a lot of previous comments by senators in 2016, like Lindsey Graham, about confirming Supreme Court justices in election years. So that's something to consider as well. And Chuck Grassley, we know that, you know, for the most part, he tends to be in line with the president and with the Republican Party. However, as Senate Judiciary Committee Chairman, he definitely holds some sway in all of this, and we know that he has been critical in the past. Excuse me, not Senate Judiciary Chairman, but someone who has been plays a big role in this realm.
Yeah, very good point. Of course, Chuck Grassley not up for re-election here pretty soon. No. Potentially could be leaving. So yeah, he doesn't have a lot of to waste when it comes to President Trump and maybe a tweet. President Trump, by the way, according to the New York Times, might announce his pick as early as tomorrow. And a lot of eyes, Julia, are on Amy Coney Barrett, the Seventh Circuit Appeals Judge from Indiana. Conservatives, evangelical conservatives, really, really like her based on her pro-life stances. What are the chances that it's going to be her that would replace Ruth Bader Ginsburg here?
You know, Baker, I think they're very high. She is someone who President Trump has floated in the past, and I think her being a woman plays a huge part into this. Remember, Ruth Bader Ginsburg was, you know, I would say a role model to women across the political spectrum due to what she achieved in her time, you know, in her long running career. She broke a lot of barriers for women in the legal world and beyond. However, for liberal women in particular, she was seen as very much of a savior, really that guiding light, if you will. A lot of liberal women looked up to her, viewed her very much as you know, someone who would you know, pass and protect their values and such on the Supreme Court. However, we know that conservatives and Republicans will want to somehow put their own pick on in that slot. So I think having a conservative woman will speak volumes for them, and I think it's Amy Coney Barrett is someone they're going to push for.
The other thing that's interesting in all this is the timing of all this. We remember with Merrick Garland, there was over 200 days before the election, and Mitch McConnell had famously said that the American public should be the ones choosing the successor here. We only have 43 days, Julia, until the election. 9 days, by the way, until the government runs out of funding. What are even the chances here that we even get a vote before Election Day on this?
I think it's very, very slim, but you are going to see Republicans push hard for this. The issue of judges, whether it's the Supreme Court justices or lower circuit judges and lower circuit courts, this is something Republicans care about, and it's something President Trump has been very good about. During his election, he has appointed lots of conservative judges across the country. And we've seen that, you know, he's done that with the support of Senate Republicans and other Republicans across the country. We know this is definitely something that galvanizes his base as well. So as President Trump trails in a number of these election polls, you're going to see, I think, Republicans really push this, definitely, because it's something that will galvanize their base. That being said, this has also galvanized the liberal base, because we know that Ruth Bader Ginsburg, like I said before, was someone who was seen as a protector of liberal and left-leaning values on the high court. So expect liberals and Democrats also to push for a protection of this vote, for this vote to be delayed until the election happens on November 3rd.
Yeah, very good point there. And we've even seen the fundraising numbers coming from Act Blue, the progressive fundraising tool, over $100 million, Julia, that they raised over the weekend. I think they got over $6 million just in the first hour or so. You mentioned a very big key here. We know Republicans are galvanized by this to go to the polls. Is this an opportunity for Joe Biden really to galvanize women voters in particular when it comes to this issue, to get them to the polls?
Absolutely, Baker. And we know that suburban women in particular are seen as a swing vote in this election. So add that onto that. And I would say that, you know, conservatives are also going to try to vie for that conservative, that swing suburban woman voter as well. So I think the messaging we're seeing on the Supreme Court justice and, you know, whether to have this vote before the election day or after the election day, the importance of the vote, you're going to see that in quite a bit of new ad messaging and messaging from both sides of this election. I just got to say, it's amazing that, you know, in this election, we have so much to talk about, whether it's the economy, the coronavirus, and now the Supreme Court. So it's voters are going to have their definitely going to get an earful, I would say.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I mean, my God, every 5 minutes a new story happens, it seems like, when things change and all of this. The other thing I think is interesting is Joe Biden's tone on how he's basically marketing this, basically saying that this is a fight over health care, mainly in particular because the Obamacare is up once again in the Supreme Court right after Election Day. Is this going to be an issue that we're going to see progressives basically say, based on this pandemic and based on the fact that President Trump wants to get rid of the Affordable Health Care Act, this is going to be a thing that galvanizes progressives to get to the polls because of health care?
100%. And this issue has worked for progressives and galvanizing liberals in the past. Just go back to 2018. We saw that Democrats running for Congress, running in even state level races, were campaigning on the issue of health care, in particular, the need to protect the Affordable Care Act. And they won big in 2018, obviously, taking back control of the House and making gains in the Senate. So definitely expect them to continue that messaging going forward this time around, not only on the pandemic, but also the Supreme Court.
All right, 43 days. Going to be the wildest 43 days, I'm sure, of our life. Julia Manchester, great to see you as always over at The Hill.